Bishop Kingsley Osagan. Amen.
Hallelujah. entitled this message, See the King in Your Kid.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. See the King in Your Kid. I want you to know that there is a King in your kid.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Though they are small, but they are mighty.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I hope you know that.
Yes.
Though they are small, but they are mighty. These same children you see today will be leading this world tomorrow.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
These same children you are looking at today will be affecting lives tomorrow.
Amen.
These same children you are looking at today, God has deposited a lot in them that we have not discovered. Hallelujah. Jesse, the father of David, never knew what was in David. Are you with me?
Yes.
No wonder when God chose David, the father never bothered bringing out David. Hallelujah. He was the last to be brought out. Even he was even reluctant to bring him out because he never knew the weight of knowledge, the kingship that was in David. And that's exactly what is wrong with many of us today. We don't even know what we are carrying. We don't know the children living in our home. We don't know what is in them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I hope we will not get old before we start to say, I don't know if this family will go become like this before we know who they are. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But their tomorrow depends on you. Their tomorrow depends on what happens to them today. Therefore, I ask us, what are we doing in order that this kingship that God has deposited in them will be manifest? Amen. I want you to know, as a parent, you have a responsibility. Of bringing up these children to the knowledge of the Lord. Hallelujah. Because what my Bible teaches me is that those that know their God, they shall never be disappointed. If you know your God, you know who you serve, you will never be disappointed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
They shall also renew their strength. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want you to know that these children you are looking at today, they have a lot in them. But for them to be able to discover who they are depends on their parents. You are there as a parent to help them discover who they are. That is why, even as they begin to develop, as they begin to start their kindergarten, their nursery, down to their primary, their secondary, down to the university, you are always there to guide them. Amen. Because if you do not guide them, they will be led astray. There are so many people today who would have been leaders, who would have been preachers, who would have been great men and women that God has chosen them to be, but because of their upbringing, they are nowhere to be found. Many are even dead. Hallelujah. So, brothers and sisters, it is our duty to help these children grow and manifest the power of God that He has deposited in them. Amen. It is very, very important as a parent to discover your children's destiny. And how do you discover their destiny? Look at what they like so much. Look at what they are interested in. Be interested in what they are interested in. But what is happening today? We want the children to be interested in what we are interested in. Praise the Lord. While I was growing up, even before I had my kids, I said, oh, if I have a daughter, I would love my daughter to play tennis. Because I love the female tennis so much. In short, it was the female tennis that made me love the male tennis that I'm now looking at both the male and the female. Amen. And I used to support Serena Williams. I'm a great follower of Serena Williams. And one day I was always telling myself, oh, if my daughter will play tennis like this, I will love it. Hallelujah. And while she's growing up, I've been putting that in her. You play tennis. I will register you with the tennis club and everything. All the time she's asking. But the other day she came and said, in my school, I love to play basket. Amen.
Amen.
I said, hey. Equation not balanced again. Deviation not come. I said, hey, you love basket. Don't you love tennis? He said, I love tennis, but I love basket. I believe my spirit told me, said, be interested in what she's interested in. Don't put in her what you are interested in. Help me, help me. And by His grace, she even brought, because in the school they gave them one flyer that you should bring them and register them in a club where they play basket. Somewhere in St. Sebastian. Do you know that I did not look at it? Until the evening of that day, they said we should bring them. She came to show me again. When I saw it, I said, oh, and it has passed. I started feeling so bad. And it was in that meditation the Holy Spirit told me this one. Be interested in what your children are interested in. And not make them be interested in what you are interested in. Amen, somebody. Praise the Lord. If I love football and my son does not love football, I should not kill him. Not everybody who plays football succeeds. Oh, Cristiano Ronaldo is a billionaire. Lionel Messi is a billionaire. You must know. Who told you his destiny is in football? Praise the Lord, somebody. David's destiny was in the palace, but the father was taking him to the backyard. The father didn't know his destiny was to be in the palace. He kept him at the backyard. He said, no, you stay here. But destiny, that's somebody who has said, destiny, brought him out. Hallelujah. Destiny brought him out. Even when he killed the lion and the bear, the father never announced it. The father covered everything, said, don't worry. Hallelujah. praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Even when Joseph exposed his destiny, the father said, me and your mama will go back before you. You know, in my place, it's a very strong word. Hallelujah. What is that? It's a very strong word. The father said, so you mean myself and your mother will bow before you? He wasn't happy with that. Amen. But that was his destiny. And what happened at last? Did they bow before him? Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Let us learn to support our children's destiny. If your child is interested in science, don't force him or her to go and study law. Because he's going to perform woefully. And you start to, hey, your parents are taking first class, you are, now you cause harm. Because from the beginning, she was going to read law. Because you want your name to hear there. My daughter is a lawyer. You know, in my place, they said, Iye lawyer, I'm here. Iye teacher, I'm here. Hallelujah. That is to say, when your son is a lawyer, when your son is a teacher, you will be very popular. Amen. Praise the Lord. But there are other courses that you will do and come out in flying colors, come out progressing in everything you do. Amen. You will do it and you'll be happy for doing it. Praise the Lord. You know, some people are doing jobs today that they are not actually interested in. They are not doing it just for doing sake. Because my father wanted me to study this. But meanwhile, the love of their life, they have left it behind. Praise the Lord. So I want to advise us parents today, let us learn to be interested in what our children are interested in. Let's not push them towards our way. If their arrow is pointing this way, don't tell their arrows to point your way. Amen, somebody. Because one of the questions I ask myself first, this way I am pushing this person to, did I follow this way? If yes, did I make it? Is it good enough for my children? Hallelujah, somebody. Let us learn to help our children grow in their own destiny. Amen. It's not many of us today only know God when we have problems. How can they grow in their own destiny? By bringing them up in the way of the Lord, first of all. Amen. You know, the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and every other shall be added. And when Jesus was asked, which one is the greatest law of the Ten Commandments? Hallelujah. And he said, the first one, love your God with all your what? That's the first one. That is to say, before I know that, the first thing is God. I feel pity for so many people today who are not bringing their children in God's way, because tomorrow many are going to weep. I pray they will not lose their children in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Many are going to lose their children, because when the society eats up these children, there's nothing you will tell them again that they will listen to. Now that their brain is still very fresh, now that they can hear you, they can listen to you, this is the best time to sow into them the knowledge of God. Many of us are still in the way of Christ today because we were brought up that way Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If we refuse to do that to our children also, we will regret it. This is not a cause. It is just natural. We will regret it. Amen. I visited a family recently and I saw the way the children were doing. And I called this person. I said, on a Sunday morning, you are sleeping, the children are sleeping. The children will only come down when they want to eat. You will never hear good morning, daddy, good morning, mommy, waking up in the morning. You nothing like morning devotion, nothing like prayers. This one will go take her own, go to the room. The other one will come, take her own. Even when they see you as an adult, they'll bypass you, no greeting, nothing. And I called the mother, I said, you are not growing your children in the way of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I said, let me tell you this. Those who are not growing their children in the way of the Lord, they will have themselves to blame in the nearest future. And that's the same word I tell you this morning. If you do not grow your children in the way of the Lord, you will have yourself to blame in the nearest future. I pray that will not be a portion in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
We should wake up and help our children grow in the knowledge of the Lord. Teach them the Bible. Give them assignments in the Bible. My book of Bible stories, get it for them. Help them. When they ask you questions, tell them how it is. That is why it is not good for you to study. Because they are going to be asking you questions. Amen. Praise the Lord. A child once asked the parents, who is the father of Jesus? He said, God. And he said, who is the father of God? The person was looking. Couldn't say anything. He repeated every time he says, Daddy, you have not told me who is the father of God. Hallelujah. The man was not confused when he said that he had to come to the church and ask. Say, Pastor, my son is asking me this question. I don't know what to say. I've been dodging it, but he's insisting. Because he knows that. Like we are now, we have a father, our father have a father. So who is the father of God? And the pastor said, so if you don't give him any answer, because you don't know the word of God. Hallelujah. And the pastor told him, he said, haven't you read in the book of Genesis? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He is the creator that cannot be created. He is the Almighty God that cannot be fathered. Hallelujah. Can't you tell your son that he is everything? Why look at your child like that? Make him understand who God is. Amen. He makes impossibility possible.
Hallelujah.
When everybody is saying it's not possible, he makes it possible. When everybody is saying it's no, he says yes. Hallelujah. When every door does are being closed, he opens. He's the only one that has the key to open every door. Once you begin to teach your children this, he will begin to see God in people. Don't just be quiet and say, I don't know the Father of God. Why? Because we don't study. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want you to know that every day with the behavior of your children, they remind you of your childhood. Hallelujah. So help them. Direct them. Bless them. Don't always pat them when they do wrong. When they also do right, praise and encourage them. Because that is the problem we are having today. We only notice our children when they are doing wrong. Hallelujah. When they are doing the right thing, you just say, oh, bravo, clap for yourself. We don't do that. But when they are doing something wrong, what are you doing there? Bow. The Bible said, spare the rod and spoil the child. Come here. Bow. That is only what we know our children. No, it shouldn't be so. At that time, you hear them singing wonderful song. At that time, you hear them reciting their recitals. At that time, you hear them even saying poem. Child, listen. After everything, plan for them, encourage them. Hallelujah. By so doing, they will be happy. And they will want to continue that way. But if you pretend not to notice, and maybe the time now they just kick to one bucket and the water pour on the floor, you stand up and open water here. Oh, you come there. Bam, bam. You are not doing the best thing to your children. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let us recognize them also. That period, they are doing the right thing. I'm also a victim of this, but I'm learning. Praise the Lord. Praise the Master Jesus. There's a King in our children. I am very sure there are leaders of this world in this place. Yes. Hallelujah. I am very sure. In the next 20 to 30 years, some of you will remind me of what I just said. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let us help them. They are like eggs that are needed to be carried carefully. If you don't carry them carefully, they will be broken. Amen. And you know what it is now? When the egg is broken, no matter, you cannot patch it. When you patch it, within three days, you go run away from your room when you put them. Amen. It cannot be patched. Once it's broken, it is finished. You see many people today, when you talk about Christ, you keep quiet. Why? Because the egg had broken. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There are so many people in the world today that are not helping matters. Many of us leaders, we are not even helping matters.